हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ अनुपम अवस्थी, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन आईएसएफ कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी। टुडे आई एम डेमोंस्ट्रेटिंग द एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑफ हाउ टू सिंथेसाइज एस्पिरिन फ्रॉम सैलिसिलिक एसिड। दिस इज ए कॉमन फार्मास्यूटिकल केमिस्ट्री प्रैक्टिकल फॉर बी फार्म एज वेल एज डी फार्म स्टूडेंट्स। नाउ कमिंग टू द टुडेज एम, एम इज दी टू सिंथेसाइज एस्पिरिन फ्रॉम सैलिसिलिक एसिड एंड रिपोर्ट इट्स परसेंटेज यील्ड। This is the chemical structure of the aspirin, and aspirin chemical name of aspirin is the 2-acetoxybenzoic acid, because at the position of second there is acetoxy group is attached, and another name is the acetyl salicylic acid, and these are the various requirements for perform this experiments. First is the chemical requirements, that is the salicylic acid, acetic anhydride and concentrate H2SO4. This is the glassware requirements, round bottom flask, beaker, measuring cylinders, funnel, glass rods. Now I am telling about the physical and chemical properties of the aspirin. Aspirin is found as a colorless crystals. It is odorless, and aspirin is soluble in chloroform and ether, slightly soluble in water, and freely soluble in alcohol. Generally aspirin is used as a painkillers, and you can say as a analgesic under the category of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, and used in inflammatory conditions such as arthritis. Now I am coming to discuss the chemical reaction behind of this synthesis. To prepare the aspirin from the salicylic acid, we have used two chemicals. First one is the salicylic acid. Salicylic acid react with the an excess amount of acetic anhydride in the presence of strong acid. Strong acid like phosphoric acid and concentrated H2SO4. Strong acid act as a catalyst which speeds up the reaction. Here in this experiment we use the concentrated H2SO4 as catalyst and push the mixture at the 50 to 60 degree centigrade on water bath for 30 minutes. After the reaction we get two compounds, crude aspirin and another is the acetic acid. As I previously discussed, aspirin is not soluble in water, whereas acetic acid is soluble in water. After the reaction, when we add the water in this mixture, aspirin acid is precipitated out and acetic acid is easily separate out from the crude aspirin after the filtration. Now I am start to perform the practical, but before starting the experiment I introduce the various chemicals and glasswares which are used in this experiment. These are the chemicals which are used in this practical: salicylic acid, second is acetic anhydride, and concentrated sulfuric acid. These are the various glassware which are used in this experiment. This is the droppers to take the liquid samples. This is the glass rod to mix the contents. This is the spatula to take the solid sample from the containers. China disc. This is the conical flask, funnel, and these are the 10 ml measuring cylinder and 50 ml measuring cylinder. This is the round bottom flask and beaker, and this is the weighing balance. Before start the practical for weigh the solid content, you should always use the butter paper. Then tear the weighing balance at zero before weighing any compounds. I am weighing the salicylic acid and quantity is 2 gram. Pour this salicylic acid into the RBF, and all glassware should be properly cleaned before performing the experiments. Now I am measuring acetic anhydride by using funnel and measuring cylinder. Then add acetic anhydride into the salicylic acid.
with continuous stirring sulfuric acid into the mixture of salicylic acid and acetic anhydride with proper mixing. Put this reaction mixture onto the water bath, which is already maintained on the 50 to 60 degree centigrade temperature, and this RBF have to put for 30 minutes on water bath. Now pour down this reaction mixture into the cold water with continuous stirring.
Now you can see after the 5 minutes of settlement, you can see the crude aspirin is settled down into this cold water by using the funnel with filter paper. With continuous stirring. Because all crude aspirin is filtered out. Now you can see the crude aspirin. Now I am performing the recrystallization method for getting the purified compound or purified aspirin by using the ethanol. Ethanol is using to remove the impurity from the solvent in which aspirin is dissolved. For recrystallization method to getting the pure aspirin, we add the small quantity of crude aspirin into the ethanol with heating with continuous stirring. Now you can see the crystal is starting here. This is the recrystallization point where the pure aspirin you can get. We put this conical flask for few hours to getting the pure aspirin crystals. Now you can see after the recrystallization we get the needle shape crystals of pure aspirin. By using this pure crystals you can get the practical yield and percentage yield, and you can also find out about the compound nature by using the NMR spectra and other techniques, and you can perform the identification test of aspirin. After getting the crystal of the aspirin, we have to calculate the percentage yield. The formula of percentage yield is percentage yield is equal to practical yield divided by theoretical yield and multiplied by 100. Then theoretical yield is equal to weight of, in case of aspirin synthesis there is a sum of weight of salicylic acid and weight of acetic anhydride. Suppose if we use quantity of salicylic acid is 1 gram and acetic anhydride is equal to 2.5 ml. Concentrated sulfuric acid is not considered in this value because concentrated H2SO4 is used as a media. So percentage yield value always calculated or obtained into the gram. Here
In case of acetic anhydride, it is the liquid. Then we have to convert the liquid into the gram by using a formula, that is the rho is equal to mass upon volume. Rho represent the density of compound. Density is mentioned of their liquid compound total. So density of acetic anhydride is the 1.08 is equal to mass is supposed is the x and volume is the 2.5 ml. Then mass or x is equal to 1.08 multiplied by 2.5, that is the 2.7 gram. Then put the value into the theoretical yield. As we previously discussed, the theoretical yield is the sum of the weight of salicylic acid, that is 1 gram, plus weight of acetic anhydride. 2.7 gram is the weight of acetic anhydride. So 1 plus 2.7 gram, so that is the 3.7 gram. So that is the theoretical yield of this reaction. Suppose we get after completion of our experiment the aspirin quantity is 2.5 gram. We assume that. So then put the value into the percentage yield formula is equal to practical yield, that is 2.5 gram divided by theoretical yield, that is 3.7, and multiplied by 100. The approximate we get 67.56%. The percentage yield of this reaction is the 67.56%. I hope you can easily understand the how can synthesize the aspirin in laboratory and how can calculate the percentage yield of any reaction. Please like, share, subscribe our YouTube channel, and any query and suggestion comments you can send a mail on our official email ID. Thank you so much for watching this video.